Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to start with English Language Standard 6, and we are going to do the revision of Chapter 3, that is the phrase and the clause. As I have already discussed, explained everything regarding that chapter, so we'll try to do a little bit revision of that chapter, and then I'll continue with the explanation of Chapter 4, that is parts of speech. In this slide, we can see revision work, some exercises. I have given five questions each of phrases and clauses I have given you to underline. This you will be doing in your classwork notebooks. And children, I hope you all know what are phrases and what are clauses, because I have already discussed in my class and explained you. And we have done one exercise based on this, even though it is not given in your books. So I have given it better, solve them, and so that you can have a good idea, have an idea about this. So now, what are phrases? I'll again repeat, words which make sense but not complete sense is called a phrase. And what is clause? Group of words which form part of a sentence, but and it contains a subject and a predicate, that is called a clause. So this one you have to do it in your notebooks. In this slide, we are going to start with Chapter 4, that is parts of speech. Now, this children, kindly note down that whatever is written, these are the notes you have to write down in your language copy. So first we'll begin with parts of speech, that is the topic. What is parts of speech? Words that are divided into different kinds. Children, remember, different classes are there, different kinds of words are there. How they are used and what work are they playing in a sentence. Okay, so that part is known as parts of speech. So we'll now find out how many types are there. There are 8 types of parts of speech. What are they? Number one, we'll see their definitions also along with the parts of speech. Noun. Noun is a word used for the name of a person, place, animal or thing. I hope everyone must have played name, place, animal, thing, which we generally play by drawing lines and all. So that is, whenever we take the name of any person, any place, any animal or anything, so that part for which we are talking about in that sentence. So whom we are talking about, who? The first thing we will ask in the sentence is who, okay, and or what we can ask. So if it is a person, if any person we are talking about, any place we are talking about, so that we can mention as noun. For example, I have given like two, I have taken from person only. You can take from animal, you can take from place, you can take from thing. So for example, Sunil, or you can also use Matt. So now next we come to an adjective. What is an adjective? A word which adds more meaning to the meaning of a noun. Now, whatever the noun is or pronoun is, like she here is the pronoun. And what I am doing is I am adding more meaning to it by adding brave to that thing. She is a girl, but what kind of girl? Brave girl. So I am adding more to noun. So this is the role of an adjective. And coming to third, that is a pronoun. It is a word which adds more meaning to a noun. Now, what is pronoun? Pronoun is also which adds more meaning to a noun. Like for example, like if I say Alok is absent because Alok is ill, it is quite odd taking two times the same name. So what we do in to avoid that thing, we use he. For instead of Alok, we use he. So here I have used he, and I have underlined also. You can see Alok is absent. Why is absent? Because Alok is ill. No, because he is ill. So I am using the pronoun he instead of noun. Okay. Now next part is a verb. What is a verb? Verb is actually a word which expresses an action, means any doing work is known as verb. Whatever, for example, if I say he is drinking tea or Suresh is drinking tea. So drinking means any activity he is doing, any work he is doing. So here this drinking is acting as a verb. So this we need to keep in mind. Here pronoun also, one thing children remember, here it's written more meaning to a noun. You cannot, instead of a noun we can use pronoun. Okay, so now coming to the fifth part, we will see in the next slide. Moving on to this slide, we can see fifth point, that is an adverb. Now what is verb first? Let us we have already done that in our previous slide. Verb is any doing activity, any action which is taking place in the sentence. So verb is that, but an adverb is adding more meaning to a verb. So how, if I say he came, so came here you can see I have written came is any activity taking place. How he came? Quickly. So I am describing more about the verb. If I said she is dancing beautifully, so dancing is the verb, but beautifully is, I am adding more to verb. So it will be known as adverb. Now coming to sixth point, we can see sixth is a preposition. Now what is preposition? It is a word used with noun or pronoun, and it shows the relationship with something else. For example, if I say the cup is on the table, so it is showing the relation of cup with table. Where it is? On the table. I can say anything like under the table, above the table. Okay, so it is on the table. So this is showing a relationship between two things. So it is showing the relationship with the noun with something else that is on the table. Table it is. Okay. Now coming to seventh point, we can see a conjunction. I hope everyone must be knowing conjunction. Conjunction is used for joining words or sentences. For example, if you say Ram and Rohan went to school but Ashok remained at home. Now see how I am connecting the sentence. I am connecting two people, you can see Ram and Rohan together, and again I am connecting the third person with but. Not always you can use and, but there are and, but, these all words you can use in conjunction while. Like while Ram and Rohan went to school but Ashok remained at home. So this is how when we join a sentence we use conjunction. These are conjunctions, and, but. Okay, number 8 is an interjection. It is used to express strong emotions or sudden feelings. For example, we can say, bravo, you have done well. Now, interjection is a very strong feeling which suddenly happens when you are excited or when you are very sad, that it comes out suddenly. Oh no, like alas, he is dead. Or bravo, or you can say, hooray, we won the match. You can say, bravo, you have done well. And it also ends with an exclamation mark, remember. So it is an interjection which is used to express feelings, strong feelings, sudden feelings. Okay, now note one thing, determiners. What are determiners? Now some grammars include determiners as parts of speech, while some do not, but some determiners are like a, and, the, this, that, and next will follow in the other slide. Coming up to this slide, we see that the next was number 6, that is these, 7, those, every, each, some, any, his, many other, etc. Okay, so it determines the limit of a noun. With this, we determine the limit of a noun. So these are known as determiners. Now, one thing you need to keep in mind is, after we use it, but how we are using in a sentence, that depends. Because we can also, you will say that miss, after here you are saying adverb, after in the second you are saying preposition, after in the second, third you are saying conjunction. How? This I am going to show you and you are going to learn. That is, first I said they arrived soon after. So what I am using, what is the verb over here? Arrived. When they arrived? Soon after. So this after here is acting as adverb, which is adding more meaning to a verb. While we see they arrived after us, here I am saying after means relationship between they and us. So after here is used as preposition. In the third we see they arrived after we had left. Now this after I am adding two sentences, that when they arrived, when we had left. So this I am showing a link, or I am adding two, you can say sentence different, they arrived, we had left. So I am adding them. So when we are using connectors, it means these are conjunctions. Conjunctions are also known as connectors because they connect two sentences or two words together. Okay, I hope children this explanation part is clear. Now we are going to solve exercise in grammar 2, which is given in page number 12 of your language book. So you can follow, because some I have done and some you have to do as your homework. So the first one is still water run deep. So here you can see all the italicized words which have been given. You have to name which part of speech it is, and you have to give reason also for your classification, why you said adjective or why you said adverb. So that part also you need to say over here. So first is still water run deep. It is an adjective. Why adjective? It is adding more meaning to a noun, water. Water is a noun over here, and it is adding more meaning to a noun. So that's why it is an adjective, because I have explained you the sentence or the word which adds more meaning to a noun is known as adjective. So here number second, you can see again still is given. He still lives in that house. So here we see that it is acting as an adverb. It adds more meaning to a verb, lives. Here we can see lives, of course a work is been done, he is living over there. So live, and I am adding still here, so it is adding more meaning to the verb live. So number third we see after the storm comes the calm, means of course after storm everything is calm. So I am adding after storm, what is happening? Calm. So this two I am linking with after, even though it is not in between, but it is acting as a preposition. So it shows the relationship between storm and comes, the calm. So comes. Okay. So here it is a preposition. Let us see in the fourth, in the next slide. Yes, in the fourth you can see the after effects of the drug are bad. Here it is playing the role of an adjective, which is adding something to the meaning of a noun, effects. Fifth, the up train is late. Of course, we are not talking about any preposition or something. We are talking about the noun train. So it adds something to the meaning of a noun train. Then number six is it weighs about a pound. So we are using here adverb. It adds something to the meaning of the verb weighs. Okay, so the weighs is verb, measuring something. So it's saying about that, so it is an adverb. Number seven, he told us all about the battle. So here battle, of course, and all, it is showing the relationships, so it is a preposition. He was also a yard off me. Now here you can see relationship between yard, only a yard of me means little bit difference was there. So that yard and me, that is showing a difference between yard and me. So we are using here OFF off. Number 9, you can see suddenly one of the wheels came off. This here we are saying something to the meaning of the verb, that is came. What happened? It came off. So came, the work which has been done, came, and off, of course, so it will be an adverb. Lastly, this one is little bit difficult, but it is not so. If you can understand nicely, Muslims fast in the month of Ramzan. Now, this fast is something else. This is not a fast we are talking about that he runs fast. It is the fast which they do. So, it is verb over here because it is doing, they are doing something, an action is there. So, it says about an action done by Muslims. So, you can say fast is a verb. Now, note children, this exercise along with the questions, you have to do it in your notebook. That is your language copies. And do the remaining sentences as your homework. I have done till 10 and till 16 it is given in your book in that exercise. So, you need to do all the remaining 6 in your notebook. And do revise the chapter entirely and thoroughly, whatever I have taught.